Let's start the topic of elasticity. And to understand elasticity, let's first take an experimental illustration. Here you can see there is a boy in front of a large block made up of rubber clamped on ground. In this situation, we can see when the boy pushes the rubber block with his hand, the block gets deformed. Just like the situation in case of a spring, when we apply a deforming force, the spring gets deformed. Or we can say some potential energy is stored in the deformation, and when the boy pulls his hand out, you can see the rubber regains its initial shape. Now in this situation, we can simply write that the property of matter, by virtue of which a body tend to regain its original shape and size after its deforming forces are removed is called elasticity. So what we have seen just now, the property of rubber because of which it has a tendency to regain its original shape, this property we call elasticity, and we can also write that elasticity is due to intermolecular forces between constituent particles of body. This is the basic definition of elasticity, and we can simply state when an elastic body or a matter is deformed, the work done in deformation is stored in the body in form of its elastic potential energy, just like the case of a spring. Like when a spring is compressed or elongated, work done on it is stored in its potential energy.